Now we need to talk about simplifying radical expressions. And before we do this, I want to point out a little bit of vocabulary I'm going to be using throughout the video. Perfect squares are numbers that you get when you square an integer. So this is 1 squared, 2 squared, 3 squared, and so on. Another way to look at perfect squares is that if you take a square root of a perfect square, you get an integer out. So the square root of 1 is 1, the square root of 4 is 2, the square root of 9 is 3, and so on. Similarly, perfect cubes are numbers that you get when you cube integers. So if you took a cube root of 1, you would get 1. A cube root of 8, you would get 2. The cube root of 27, you would get 3, and so on. Now these numbers are going to be important when it comes to simplifying radical expressions. Here's an example. If I want to simplify the square root of 12, you'll notice that the number 12 has a perfect square factor in it. We can write 12 as 4 times 3. And as it turns out, if we have multiplication under a radical, we can split that radical up into two pieces. And since we have the square root of a perfect square here, we can just write this piece as 2 and leave the square root of 3. So this is considered the simplified version of the square root of 12. And the only reason I chose to split 12 up into 4 and 3 is because 4 is a perfect square and it simplifies. You'll notice that you can't simplify the square root of 3 any further. And on that note, as an example, the square root of 11 is already considered to be simplified because you can't pull any perfect squares out of it. Let's do another example. Let's simplify the square root of 48. Basically, what we're wondering is, are there any perfect square factors in the number 48 that we could take out? And the answer is yes. 48 can be written as 16 times 3, and 16 is a perfect square. The square root of 16 is 4, and the square root of 3 is already simplified, so we just have to leave it. Now you might be asking, what if I didn't see that right away? What if I saw the square root of 48 and I thought, well, we can split that up into 4 times 12. Okay, that's great. The square root of 4 is 2, and the square root of 12 actually can be simplified further now. We can split 12 then up into 4 times 3. We leave the 2, the square root of 4 is 2, and the square root of 3 just has to be left. And then you'll notice that 2 times 2 is just 4. So we have 4 times the square root of 3 left over, which is the same result that we got up here. It just took a couple of extra steps. So that's just another way to simplify the square root of 48. All right, let's try another one. Let's try to simplify the cubed root of 16. So if you have a cube root that you're simplifying, you're looking for perfect cubes under the radical. And your list of small perfect cubes are right here. You'll notice right away that 16 has a factor of 8 in it. So we can split this up into the cube root of 8 times 2. Cube root of 8, we know, is the number 2. And the cube root of 2, well, it's just the cube root of 2. And that's how the answer is going to have to stay. Okay, a quick note here. We have perfect squares. We have perfect cubes. We have perfect fourths as well. The numbers get really big really fast, so I really only know 1, 16, and 81. This is 1 to the 4th, 2 to the 4th, 3 to the 4th, and there are perfect fifths and so on as well. All right, let's finish this video up with a few examples of simplifying problems. We're going to do a lot more of these in class. And as always, feel free to hit pause on the video to slow things down, but I'm going to run through these. First problem, we have a fourth root of 32, and you'll notice that our list of perfect fourths is 16. 32 is 16 times 2. The fourth root of 16 is 2. The fourth root of 2, we can't simplify any further, so you just have to leave it as is. The square root of 100 wasn't a very good problem, so I'm going to change it to the square root of 50. You think about your list of perfect squares, and on there is 25. And 50 is 25 times 2. The square root of 25 is 5. And the square root of 2 can't be simplified. Okay, as always, we have to start dealing with variables, not just numbers in these problems. We have x cubed under a square root. And you're thinking about how to take a perfect square out of this x cubed. Well, this is the first time you're seeing it, so I'll just show you. X squared is a perfect square, and x cubed can then be written as x squared times x. Now, the square root of x squared, as we talked about in class, is the absolute value of x. So that's that piece right there. What's left is just the square root of x, which can't be simplified further. So that is the answer. How about a cube root of x to the 7th? Well, what we're looking for is to pull a perfect cube out of this radicand. And the way to do this is to pull out an x to the 6th. So we're rewriting x to the 7th as x to the 6th times x. Now, the cube root of x to the 6th turns out to just be x squared. And what's left here is the cube root of just x, which can't be simplified further. So that is our final answer right there. Okay, we'll do a lot more of these in class. I'll see you there.